كتاب الله دستوري وخير الخلق أسوتنا.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وظللنا عليكم الغمام وأنزلنا عليكم المن والسلوى كلوا من طيبات ما رزقناكم وما ظلمونا ولكن كانوا أنفسهم يظلمون. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. فالحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. قرآن ويكلي. Today I want to share with you some things from the 57th ayah of Surah Al-Baqarah. And in this ayah, Allah Azza wa Jal is addressing the Banu Israel, the children of Israel, and he mentions some of his favors. The reason I wanted to share this ayah with you though is because of a powerful transition that happens inside this ayah. And in order for you to understand that transition, I'm going to lay out a scene for you first. That scene is of a teacher in a classroom, and he's got, let's just say, two sections of students. Okay, so there are students on the left side, and there's a little bit of a gap, and there's students on the right side. And the people on the left side, they took the exam yesterday. Okay, so group A, we'll call them group A, they took the exam yesterday, and they failed. And then group B is about to take the exam tomorrow. So this is the day in between. Teacher walks into class, he's yelling at group A, the one who already took the test, because they failed. And he's yelling at them like, I did so much for you. I did the review for you. I gave you all the answers. I even gave you a copy of the test the day before. How could you still fail? I don't understand what more I could do for you. And then while he's yelling at them, group B is sitting there watching. Now some of them are smirking and like, haha, those guys, they really got it. But others of them, the smarter ones among them, are terrified as this is happening because they know that their exam is the next day. And they might be getting the same kind of thrashing pretty soon. Now the teacher says, you people, you know what? I can't even talk to you anymore. He ignores group A as though he is so angry at them they aren't even worthy of being addressed. Then he turns to group B and says, by the way, your exam's tomorrow. He just says that. And by the way, those people, they didn't fail me, they failed themselves. He turns towards them and says that. Now, I want you to remember this scene as I describe something about this ayah, just so it's easier to understand. Allah is addressing who again? He's addressing the sons of Israel. He says, وَظَلَّلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْغَمَامِ. We shaded you, we put shade over you by means of clouds that are filled with rain. So these rainy clouds or soft clouds, you can say غَمَام, or even darker clouds that can prevent sunlight. So, because they're in the desert and they're in the Exodus, so Allah miraculously covered them with the umbrella from the sky. You know, clouds would follow them. Number one. وَأَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَنَّ وَالسَّلْوَى. And we even sent down onto you al-manna and salwa. Manna and salwa were, you know, it's a kind of wheat that they could grow in the middle of the desert. Allah would send grain down that they could grow and make bread with. And salwa was a kind of bird that they would try and catch and it wouldn't fly away. So miraculously, their proteins and carbohydrates are taken care of. Their shade is taken care of. And eventually Allah will provide them, you know, the spring of water, the 12 springs that you know about. You know, that'll, so their water is taken care of. So they're surviving through impossible odds. And this is the list of favors. I did this for you, I did this for you, I did this for you. Okay. وَأَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَنَّ وَسَلْوَى. Then he says, كُلُوا مِن طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. Eat, consume from the good things, the pure things of what we've provided you, what the provisions we've given to you. Then, all of this, if you notice, was in the you, meaning ظَلَّنَا عَلَيْكُمْ, we shaded you, we put clouds over you, we sent manna and salwa onto you. Eat, when you give a command to somebody, eat from the good things that we've provided you. You know, all of this, the word you here suggests second person. And the logic behind second person is you're talking to someone. But now notice the end of the same ayah. وَمَا ظَلَمُونَا وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. As opposed to the Arabic would have been, وَمَا ظَلَمْتُمُونَا وَلَكِنْ كُنْتُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ تَظْلِمُونَ. You used to be wronging yourselves. Nope, he doesn't say that. He says, they didn't wrong us, they were only wronging themselves. So in other words, half the ayah is in the you, it's in the second person. The other half of the ayah is in the third person, it's in the they, as though they're not there. And even if they are there, the point of it is, Allah is no longer going to address them. Now think about the teacher. The teacher yells at one group, He's so disappointed with them that they're not even worthy of mention anymore. He doesn't want to talk to them anymore. So he turns over and he turns to the other group and says, by the way, they didn't disappoint me. Now the ayah says, وَمَا ظَلَمُونَا, they didn't wrong us, they were only wronging themselves. They were only wronging themselves. Now what's the point of this transition? The point of this transition is that we don't read the ayat about the Jews and the ayat about previous nations, and especially the Jews, I would argue. We don't read ayat about them and say, look at what Allah says about the Jews. Allah really got them good. Look at all the things Allah did for them. But the ayah wasn't about them. The ayah was half about them and the other half, hey, you're up next. Batter's up. Get ready. And you better not fall into this kind of trouble yourselves. It's incredible that through the ayat of Banu Israel, I know you've probably heard it in lectures before, that we should learn about the nations of the past so we don't repeat their mistakes. Actually, that's not just an analysis that we drew. It's actually embedded into the Quran itself. He doesn't let us read Jewish history without thinking about ourselves. And you better not fall into this mistake yourself. So the wrong thing to get, the wrong impression to get from the history of Bani Israel, the Jewish history in the Quran, the wrong impression to get is a sense of supremacy. And the right attitude to get is a sense of humility. Like, Ya Allah, we're in the same exact position they were in before. And we better not disappoint you, because then this exact criticism that you're laying out for them applies to us 100%. So may Allah Azza wa Jal make us of the people who understand and reflect on the way Allah is teaching us. You know, وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ. Allah is teaching you and Allah knows everything. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us good students of His book. بارك الله لي ولكم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
آمنت بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر والقدر خيره وشره من الله والبعث بعد الموت لا إله إلا الله. آمنت بالله وملائكته